Richard Feynman was a theoretical physicist who made significant contributions to the development of electrodynamics and the understanding of subatomic particles. He discussed various aspects of energy throughout his career and is famously quoted as saying, "It is important to realize that in physics today, we have no knowledge of what energy is." This statement reflects the idea that although physicists have a deep understanding of how energy behaves and can predict its effects in various systems, the underlying nature of energy is still not fully understood. Let's try to explain in the simplest way possible what we currently know about the various aspects of energy. Energy is the ability to do work. In simple terms, energy is what allows things to happen or work. For example, when you turn on a light bulb, the electrical energy is converted into light energy that allows you to see in the dark. Energy can be measured using various units, but the most common ones are joules, J, and kilowatt hours, kWh. Joules are a standard unit of energy used to measure the energy required to perform work, such as lifting an object or heating water. Kilowatt hours are a unit of energy used to measure the amount of electricity consumed over time. For example, if you use a 100-watt light bulb for 10 hours, you have consumed 1 kilowatt hour of electricity. Energy can take many forms, including thermal, kinetic, potential, electrical, chemical, nuclear, and electromagnetic energy. This means that energy can exist in different states and can be transferred from one form to another. For example, when you light a match, the chemical energy stored in the matchstick is converted into thermal energy that produces the flame. The law of conservation of energy states that energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred, or transformed from one form to another. This principle means that the total amount of energy in a closed system remains constant, and energy cannot be created or destroyed, only converted into other forms of energy. The last state of energy transformation is the heat that we don't know how to transform into something else. An example of the law of conservation of energy is a roller coaster ride. A roller coaster at the top of a hill has potential energy due to its position above the ground. As the coaster goes down the hill, this potential energy is converted into kinetic energy, which is the energy of motion. As the coaster reaches the bottom of the hill, it has maximum kinetic energy and minimum potential energy. As the coaster goes up another hill, it slows down, and its kinetic energy is converted back into potential energy. The total energy of the coaster, potential energy plus kinetic energy, remains constant throughout the ride, in accordance with the law of conservation of energy. Naturally, some of the energy is transformed into heat, due to friction. Therefore, the hills of the roller coaster have progressively lower heights. Let us now look at some aspects related to the use of energy in modern society. Currently, the debate is related to energy sources, renewable and non-renewable. Fossil fuels, coal, oil, and natural gas, are non-renewable energy sources that are formed over millions of years from the remains of dead plants and animals. Fossil fuels are finite resources and take a long time to form. They are also major contributors to climate change due to the release of carbon dioxide when burned. Renewable energy sources, such as solar, wind, hydro, and geothermal energy, are replenished naturally and can be used without depleting them. Currently, the use of renewable energies is still limited by technical and economic factors. Let's see some examples of renewable energy. Fusion energy. Scientists are working on developing practical methods for harnessing fusion energy, which is the same process that powers the sun. Fusion has the potential to provide abundant energy with virtually no greenhouse gas emissions and very small quantities of radioactive waste and low emissions. Recent advances in fusion technology, such as the ITER project in France, are making fusion energy closer to reality. Solar power. Solar power is becoming increasingly popular as the cost of solar panels continues to drop. Recent breakthroughs in solar technology, such as perovskite solar cells, have the potential to make solar energy even more efficient and affordable. Energy storage. One of the challenges of renewable energy sources like wind and solar power is that they are intermittent and dependent on weather conditions. Energy storage technologies, such as batteries and pumped hydro storage, are becoming increasingly important for storing excess energy and using it when needed. Carbon capture and storage. Carbon capture and storage, CCS, is a technology that captures carbon dioxide emissions from power plants and industrial processes and stores them underground. CCS has the potential to significantly reduce greenhouse gas emissions from fossil fuel use. Hydrogen fuel cells. Hydrogen fuel cells convert hydrogen gas into electricity, with water as the only byproduct. Fuel cell technology has the potential to provide clean, efficient power for a range of applications, including transportation and energy storage. In some cases, the adoption of new technologies such as fuel cells and rechargeable electric batteries is being evaluated as doubts arise about their effective environmental harmlessness. The use of renewable energy can reduce greenhouse gas emissions and help mitigate climate change. Climate change is caused by the accumulation of greenhouse gases, such as carbon dioxide, in the atmosphere. The use of renewable energy can reduce the amount of greenhouse gas emissions from energy production and help to slow down the rate of climate change. Energy efficiency refers to using less energy to perform the same task, and it can save money and reduce energy waste. By using energy-efficient appliances and equipment and implementing energy-efficient practices in buildings and industries, we can reduce our energy consumption and save money on energy bills. The energy industry is complex and includes energy production, distribution, and consumption. The energy industry involves the extraction, processing, and transportation of energy sources, such as oil, gas, and coal, as well as the production, distribution, and consumption of electricity. Energy policy is a set of rules and regulations that govern energy production, distribution, and consumption. Energy policy is important to ensure that energy is produced and used efficiently, sustainably, and in a way that is beneficial to society. Energy access is a global challenge, with an estimated 770 million people worldwide lacking access to electricity and 2.6 billion people relying on traditional biomass for cooking and heating. Energy access is essential for economic development, education, healthcare, and overall well-being. Improving access to clean, affordable, and reliable energy is crucial for achieving sustainable development goals.